Hey there, this is Mason with DB Services, and today I'm going to be showing you how to integrate your FileMaker solution with Microsoft OneDrive. So to begin, let's start by going through this checklist that we have in the sample file included in the article. So the first thing we need to do is register a new OAuth application with Microsoft. So we click on this. This will take us to our applications we have set up. Go ahead and go to my app list. You might need to log in before you get here. Let's go ahead and add an app. Just call this article test. And let that go. All right, next thing we need to do is click the generate new password button. So generate new password. Make sure you save this. You won't be able to get it back later. And we just put it in this field right here. And then the application ID is right here. So we'll put that in there. And those are both done. Next, we need to set the home URL. So our homepage URL doesn't really matter. You can use anything as long as it's a valid URL. You could use google.com if you wanted. But whatever you use here, make sure you do the same thing here. Next, we need to add a platform and set it up for web. And then we have to set up our redirect and our logout URLs. So we're not actually going to be using these, so I'm just going to put in the same URL. Next, we need to set up our graph permissions. So I'm going to go ahead and click add here. And we need to set up the add the files read write all delegated permission. So just look through these till you get to the files. Files read write all. And then while we're in here, we don't need the users read, so we'll just take that off and click OK. So you should just see this one here. So that is it for this. Let's go ahead and save that. The default directory, this is where you want to store all your folders and files that FileMaker is uploading. So the root directory means that it's literally at the top level of your OneDrive. But let's say you wanted to store everything in your documents directory here. You could grab this ID here. And you could plug that in here, and then whenever we upload anything, it would get saved here instead. For this demo, we'll stick to root. And the next thing we need to do is connect. So I'm going to go ahead and log in with my live account. And it's going to tell me that the article test needs permission to do these things to have access to my files and maintain access to data. So we'll say yes. And we are connected. So we can go to our sample. And you'll see that we have our client ID, secret, access code, and all that has been filled in. So for the demo file, the idea is you would, you maybe have some customers. So let's say we have the test. Customer, and maybe you want to store some documents related to this customer. What we could do is let's just go ahead and upload something from here. Just drag that in here. So I got a quote here. We'll upload that, and what it's going to do is it's going to create a new folder. Which you'll see, test customer, gave it that name. And it generated a folder ID, which we'll store. And for all future calls, we'll store use that. And you'll also notice that we have a little thumbnail of our PDF. So we're not actually storing the PDF in FileMaker. That is going to be stored here. But we do want to usually have a little representation of what it is, and we can do that there. So now that we have our folder, and we can do that here. Let's say we want to just, maybe it's a little easier for us to upload lots of documents. We can just drag and drop it through the web interface here. So I'm going to upload those two documents. And let's give it a second to generate the thumbnails. Let's refresh that. All right, those are both done. So over here, I can click my refresh button, and this is going to download those as well. And yeah, so that's how you can upload. This will click to refresh and download anything new that's been added. If you actually want to access it, you obviously don't want to always go to your OneDrive and then download it. So you can download it directly from here. So let's click download. And so it's already downloaded it, and it saved it into a container for us, just a global container. Let's go ahead. And now it's just exporting from that container, you know, wherever I'm going to put it on my desktop. And now we have our PDF back. And so this keeps the size of your database really small and allows for some other cool stuff. Let's go ahead and delete this. And so delete. Notice it should go pretty quickly. This screenshot should be deleted. There it goes. So I'm going to go ahead and walk through the upload process, because that is probably the trickiest part of this whole integration. So let's go ahead and upload that screenshot again. And we'll just turn on our debugger and walk through this together. And let's get our data viewer up as well. All right. So let's step over some of this stuff. All right, we're refreshing our token. So we have a new access token. And all right. So the first thing you'll notice is that at the very start, when we're uploading this, we're actually storing everything into a global container momentarily till we can upload it. And when it's in a container, we can get the file size using the get container attribute. So this document I'm trying to upload has, this is the size of the byte. So this, you know, a lot of bytes. And then we can also from that determine the content range. Microsoft API allows you to upload files in chunks, but we're always just going to be doing the entire file at once. So if you look at the content range, you can see that the number of bytes we're doing is, the content range is one less than the total size of the document. So if we have, you know, 331093 bytes, we're going to be doing content range 0 through 331092. And that's because the range is starts at 0 and the total starts at 1. So it's just a 0 index versus a 1 index. And that's probably one of the trickier things because the documentation isn't super clear about that. And then the other thing is that's a little tricky is the URL. So first thing we're going to do is we're going to create an upload session. So if you look at this URL, and also just so you know, this might differ slightly depending on if you have a school account, business account, shared drives and stuff. So you'll have to check the documentation to get the exact location, but it should be something similar to this. So I am uploading to this folder. So this is my folder ID, and then you'll notice there is a colon to indicate the end of the ID, and then I have a URL encoded file name here. So that's the name of the file, just URL encoded, and then a colon at the end of that as well. And we are creating an upload session, and we're going to send it, we're going to be posting some JSON to it. So let's look at the curl of that. Yeah, so we're going to be posting data and our header. So this is our authorization token. This is the format we can do that in. And we also need to tell the Microsoft One API that we are doing, we expect JSON and we're sending JSON, and also the data that we're sending. And we are, the data is just a little bit of JSON. We're telling it if there's a conflict, we want to rename the file we're uploading. We can give it a description if we want, and then we also give it the name. One thing to note is you're not going to be able to generate this using standard the JSON functions FileMaker gives you. FileMaker will not allow you to put a period in the middle of an object name like this, because it just won't work. It's going to think you want everything underneath the Microsoft key, and then sub thing under graph, and then a sub object called conflict behavior. So the only way to do that is just basically to use a string and just generate it, which is what I'm doing right here. So I'm just doing a string, and then I'm just substituting out my file name where I want it. And I'll show you that in a little bit more detail in a second. So once we do the actual post, we get back our JSON. So this is the same concept, but the data it returns has a period in the object name. So I'm substituting anything with at odata dot, and I'm just stripping it out. And that's what I'm doing right here. So I'm just substituting anything with odata for nothing. And then from my file JSON, I can actually parse this now. And it's a little hard to read. So let's go ahead and add that to our watch variables. And we'll just wrap this in a JSON format elements. All right, that's a little easier to read. So we got the context. This is how the expiration date, time. This is how long we have to upload it. If we were doing chunks, we would want to know the next expected range. Since we're just doing one upload, we don't care about that. This is what we really care about, is the upload URL. This is where we will be uploading the actual upload to. This is where we're going to post the file to. And so once we have that, so we got the URL from our upload URL, and we're going to set our data just to the container, and that will actually store a link. When you set a variable directly to a container like that, it'll actually, FileMaker is smart enough to understand that you want the actual contents of that container file in the variable. And then the curl, let's show you what that looks like for this call. So we're actually not posting, we're actually putting, because you could potentially be uploading multiple times different ranges of the file, but this time we're just going to be putting one time. And the OneDrive API will know that once we've reached this byte number that we're done with our upload, and it'll finish the upload. And then we just need to do the dash T. This is the flag in curl that tells it that we're uploading a file. And then we're just including our variable there. So we can do that. We insert. Takes a minute. And we should get back in our results. Again, I'm just going to add this and format it so we can read it a little better. Oops. There we go. So this is basically the file that got uploaded, and it has all the information about it so that we can store it and create a new record in our database. The only thing that we're missing from this is the thumbnail. It just doesn't include it after you uploaded it. So, but we do get the ID, which is what we really need. So we can grab the object ID, which we did there. Typically, we don't need to do it now because we are stepping through it slowly. But normally, you want to give it a little bit of time for the API to generate a thumbnail. If you do it immediately after, it won't have the thumbnail ready. So we just do a call to the ID, and we have to pass in this flag saying include thumbnails. And then we can parse the full details. So my file JSON should now have, should have left that in there. So you'll notice now in my file JSON, I have this thumbnails object with an array of three different sizes. I have my large, which are 477 by 800. So this, you know, you could really grab whatever size you want. I'm typically sticking to the small, which is 96 by, you know, whatever the height is. All right. So once we have that, just parse all that information out so we can create our new file. So now we're actually saving it to the portal, and then we also need to download the thumbnail. So we grab that thumbnail URL right here, and we're just inserting it, doing one more call to insert it into our container. And then we are done. And we should have our file right there. Yeah, so that's the trickiest. The rest is actually a little bit simpler. The only last thing I'll mention, as could be a little confusing, it was to me. Let's say I'm trying to delete this. When I go to delete it, let's just skip right to it. All right, so when I actually run the command to delete this, it's going to come back and say, hey, requested data is missing. This is because the Microsoft API doesn't return anything when the delete goes through successful. It doesn't return JSON saying, you know, no errors or anything like that. So FileMaker is just, it's expecting results from this call, but there are none. So, yeah, and you'll notice that, yeah, I did in fact delete it. So that's just a little quirk that you'll need to be aware of. Yeah. That is all. Hopefully you liked this video and this article, and hopefully it helps you integrate your OneDrive with FileMaker.